You only live once. Years ago, the father she hardly knew told her so. She wasn't sure she believed him. Just in case he was right, she wanted no regrets. The air was cold, so cold it threatened to seep into her chest cavity if she didn't generate some soul-warming heat. Gina stood on her tiptoes and peered over the edge of the boulder. A wisp of wind surged against her face as she looked down at the desert gorge below. She readied herself by taking a deep breath. Gina shivered, rubbed her hands together, blew on them. Time seemed to freeze as she peered down, seeking the courage to leap. Just leap. Just let the wind take her in its omniscient arms and decide where to escort her. After all, if she decided to jump, she was sure to be a gnat in gale force winds, even with the courage of a great bald eagle. She had to jump. It was now or never. Thank goodness she had glider's wings strapped to her. A sudden touch on her right shoulder jolted her. She jerked to the left, and her foot slipped out from under her. The scream echoed in her ears before Gina realized it was her own. In an instant, Gina landed face down, sliding backward as gravel and pebbles scraped her entire body, sand vanishing beneath her. Somehow it seemed through sheer will. Her velocity slowed and she was able to use every inch of her body, from her face to her feet, just enough to impede her slide. In the blink of an eye, she found herself gripping the underside of the cliff as the swirling breeze tried to claim her.
"Todd! Help, Todd, please!"
she yelled. As her cries echoed, she felt two hands grip her ankles.
"I have you, Jin. Just relax."
She shut her eyes and prayed she would again be able to open them. The breeze spiraled around her like ghosts on roller coasters, taunting her, urging her to join in the fun. Her heart raced. Gina gasped for air, afraid she may scream again. The hands around her ankles tightened once more. When the grip became a vice that was sure to break her skin, she was yanked backwards and found herself resting on solid ground. Todd embraced her as though it were their last hug. Gina felt his chest press into her breasts, his arms becoming taut steel, his heartbeat hummingbird quick as he refused to let her go. Her nerves pieced back together breath by breath. Only when her shivers subsided did she let herself relax and begin to cry. For what felt like an hour, Gina and Todd stayed entwined.
"Should we go, Jin?" Todd finally broke the silence.
"No, I have a surprise for you."
By now the sun had all but set. Only a few red pepper slivers were still visible in the twilight sky. The moon was edging closer, but the sun insisted on leaving its mark. With her boyfriend holding her hand, Gina stood up, pulled him to his feet, and led him to his white Chevy Blazer. It stood out well in the darkness, worn and dented but still strong, like a storm-tested soldier. She felt Todd's pull strengthen as he walked toward the passenger door, but she resisted.
"Sweetie, I still have a surprise for you, remember? I didn't want to leave just yet."
Since Todd had planned their day, Gina had taken it upon herself to contribute a fitting end. There had been a near catastrophe, but she could still salvage her plans. This day, the last day of summer before they both geared up for college, was one she wanted them both to remember forever. Right now, it seemed like anything but just a summer afternoon. Gina heard Todd's key chirp open the locked doors as she circled toward the back of the truck, pausing at the tailgate.
"What are you doing?" he asked.
"I told you, my dear, you gave me a surprise, now I have to give you yours," she said with a grin as she plucked the picnic basket out of the back of his truck.
Without a word, Gina handed him the blanket she'd brought along and pressed it into his left arm. Then, grabbing his right arm, she pulled him alongside her to a large patch of grass beneath a willow tree, eyeing the moon before she put down the basket. Too much light was going to ruin everything. Too little and they couldn't see. Romance required balance. Yes, romance. Even if he didn't know the meaning of the word, there still might be time to teach him. Still in a shawl of silence, Gina held out her hands for the blanket. Todd offered it to her. As she took it, she looked into his eyes, sure she'd be able to spot his slightest clue as to her plans. She unfolded the quilt and placed the picnic basket in its center. Then she put a candle in each corner, each in a polished silver holder, and lit each wick.